Hey, what's going on everyone? Hope you're all having an awesome day. I'm Sam and today's video is on M1 Finance versus Ally Invest Managed Portfolio and how does the Robo-Advising fare against my personal growth portfolio? Let's see which way is the best way to automate your investing goals. Before we start, please smash that like button down below for the YouTube algorithm. Also, please subscribe. I post videos 3 times a week about investing and career advice. Much appreciated. So let's begin with what an overview of is the Ally Invest Managed Portfolio. So it's their robo-advising platform. A lot of companies are offering this. So if you're investing at least $100, there's no advisory fees, no annual charges, no rebalancing fees. Also, 30% of your portfolio is set aside as an interest earning cash buffer. And their cash buffer is the same as what their online savings account would offer. So I'm currently using them for mostly just the online savings account, but I wanted to see how their robo-advising works and how competitive it would be. Maybe it can even beat my own M1 Finance portfolio. So this is showing you what that looks like, cash buffer here. Some highlights of what this robo-advisor is. It's a hand-selected portfolio by a team of specialists. Manage, monitor daily with their smart technology. You can view the progress and track your goals 24/7. So they got 4 portfolio choices based on what matters to you. They've got an income, which is more of a dividend conservative profile. They got a core, which will have some, you can toggle how aggressive you want to be or how conservative you want to be. They're going to mix it with domestic, international, and fixed income assets. They got a tax optimize if that's something more you're looking at. Also socially responsible. So they'll track companies that have an ethical records moving towards, you know, sustainability, energy efficiency, things that if they're important to you from a social perspective, that's nice to know. So let's hop into the performance of my portfolio. So you can see currently I put in $1,000 as of December 20th. So we're almost a month in now. The performance is at 2% return, $20 up. In comparison to the US stock, it's slightly lagging since inception. You can see here, and this is how they break it down. There's a balance, withdrawals, capital, interest paid so far, account value. Hopping over here, you can see the portfolio allocations. So you can see that they've got 40% in the US stocks, 25% international. You can see how this is all breaking down, 30% cash buffer. And it's set up as the core aggressive account growth. That was the highest, most competitive portfolio that they had. So this is showing the breakdowns of those stocks, the ETFs that are in there. So you can see there's core, there's some developed markets, mid caps, emerging. So they've got a really well rounded portfolio set up for you. Also some bonds are set up as well. So you can, you know, have some safe cash set aside, and also that 30% cash buffer, which is earning interest based on whatever their online savings account is. So it's nice that that money won't be in the market, so it's kind of protected against anything. And if we hop over here, this is showing the goal tracker. So I set a goal of 100K just for fun. And then you can see that if you add a certain amount of money, so you add 373 a month, and as you're tracking, you're more likely to hit that goal. There are some here where you can input some factors to see if you play around, you know, how quickly you could hit your goal much quicker, your time horizon, the regular distribution. So let's say you decide to put in $500 every month. You could calculate that, and it would give you just how much quicker you could attain that goal or where you'd be at. And again, set up the aggressive growth. So if we hop over here, this is showing the manage goal tab. So this is all from right here. These are all tabs from here, but you can see that I set a 15-year horizon just for fun. Then there's a 100K goal I set. I've saved 120 so far. They tell you the risk tolerance, which is high. Got 1 month in of 15 years. So these are just some goals there. So now let's see how this compares to my M1 performance. So my M1 performance here is the growth portfolio that I have set up. It's showing that the tech, I have 4 different slices. So right now I'm doing better than my Ally Invest robo-advising portfolio. You see that's a 7.75 performance return, up $33. I started around the same time, December 19. So I'm going to be able to track this. I want to see how this does over the long period. So I'm going to look over a year and see, you know, which one actually comes up on top. So this is just showing you quickly. I'll show you what my slices look like. So I've got a tech cloud here. You know, there's some high value stocks in there, some expensive stocks, but it's nice that you can set up your percentages so you can kind of build a portfolio that matches what your goals are. And you know, the accounts that you, the stocks that you want to follow that you think have some really good opportunities. So these are some of the financial stocks I have set up in there. And if you go over here, there's some REITs, so I can build up some dividends on the side. Also some, you know, because those are some good accounts to have set up for building dividends. Also consumer spending is a category, which is more so just a general consumer spending category. I have Home Depot, Walmart, Procter & Gamble, 3M, Starbucks, so just some random stocks in there that are more consumer related. There's definitely room in my M1 portfolio to trim that down and to make it more refined, because right now I have 89 stocks in there, so definitely want to trim that down. It's quite a bit. But just for a quick comparison, I'm going to send you guys over to the mobile views just in case you wanted to see what those look like. Personally, I like having investing platforms that are mobile friendly. You know, they have Face ID, all these types of technologies that can protect you, and just also so you can be more readily available to make your adjustments and just view things. So I'll send that over real quick. Alright, so to quickly recap, looks like so far M1 Finance, my growth portfolio, is outperforming the robo-advising of Ally Invest. Like I said before, I'll continue to monitor this progress over the year and report back, but so far my M1 portfolio is crushing it. Right now I currently have about $400 going in there every month. I've got $200 going in every bi-weekly. You can see there's an order queued up. So this is my holdings here. You can see that the top positionings are those top tech accounts. And what's nice is that you can see all these dividends start to trickle in. It's cool getting those notifications if you don't mind them, but it's cool to see, you know, all the dividends that are popping in, very slowly accruing them, but it's nice to get that, you know, satisfaction. So what do you guys think about the Ally Invest Managed Portfolio Robo-Advising? There are a lot of companies offering this service right now. You know, how does this compare to something like a mutual fund? I'm kind of curious what you guys think. And would you like me to review the other ones out there? Let me know in the comments below. Love to hear your opinion. Thanks for watching. See you all soon, and stay humble, Outliers.